Hello, welcome back to my channel. In this new video I will show you something maybe a little bit different from what you are used to see in this channel. You will remember I'm currently working on a tube stereo amplifier, and of course as every stereo system is not complete without a proper set of speakers, in this new video I will describe a new project which is exactly a pair of matching speakers for my stereo tube amplifier. So I hope you enjoy the video and thank you very much for your attention. So these are the two speakers at the current completion stage. As you can see, they are almost completed. Just the only part which is missing is the front frame, where I will put this kind of grill cloth material. As you can see, these are two ways design. So we have a woofer. This is an 8-inch woofer, and we have a tweeter. And this is a sealed enclosure designed. I really prefer this kind of designs over the bus reflex. So this is not bus reflex. It's a sealed, completely closed design. Just one mention. This is a removable cover, which I will utilize in order to work on the crossover, as I expect some fine tunings on the crossover will be needed. Here you can see a little bit more detail on the two loudspeakers I have deployed. This is a Ciare tweeter. Is an 8 ohm component, and this is a vintage woofer, an 8 inch Philips woofer, where I replaced the foam surround. This is the crossover. It's a second order, so you can see this big coil and this capacitor are part of the low pass section for the woofer, and this capacitor, this red capacitor plus this smaller coil are part of the high pass section for the tweeter, plus a resistor, you cannot see because it's in the background, a resistor for the tweeter, because as it happens in many loudspeaker designs, the tweeter is more sensitive than the woofer, so it needs to be attenuated a little bit. This crossover came from listening tests, adjustments already, but nevertheless I was not completely happy about the sound coming from the speakers. So I would like now to report about the following adjustments, fine tunings I have implemented on the crossover design. And first of all, of course, it's very important to carefully measure the, for example, the frequency response of the speaker. And here you can see the reason why at that time the sound was not completely good to my ears. You can see here the measured frequency response, and you can see the two pretty high peaks, one centered around 1 kHz and another one centered around 12 kHz. The most impacting one on the sound was the peak centered around 1 kHz. This little bit nasty 1 kHz peak comes essentially from two contributions. The first contribution is the tweeter response. 1 kHz is close to the resonance frequency of the tweeter. Second contribution is the woofer. As I implemented a second order low pass filter, we have a little bit of resonance around 1 kHz. So in order to mitigate all that, I implemented two solutions. The first was to invert the tweeter. In this way, the emission from the tweeter is no more in phase with the emission from the woofer around the crossover frequency. So the two emissions will somewhat null each other, close to the crossover frequency. So I expect this action will mitigate a little bit the response at 1 kHz. Second solution was to include a damping resistor in the low pass section of the crossover. In this way, the typical Q, the typical resonance we have in this case at 1 kHz coming from the second order low pass filter gets again mitigated. You can see the result. This is the new frequency response according to the actions I have described. So you can see a little bit better behavior. Also, the speakers sounded much better in this way. Still, you can see a little bit of a peak around 1.3, 1.4 kHz, which of course will be subject of the next actions. You can still see the big peak at 12 kHz. To be honest, this is not this was not so sound impacting. Some can even find it pleasing, but yeah, I would like anyway to mitigate a little bit. In order to exactly do that, so in order to reduce this 12 kHz peak, I implemented a notch filter on the tweeter section of the crossover. You can see this capacitor, resistor, and inductance in parallel. These form a notch filter, which is of course centered around 12 kHz. You can see here the result, pretty nice, I would say. So as you can see, this peak is lowered. I didn't want to lower that much because, of course, this notch filter might have effect also on other parts of the pass band, which I don't want. But yeah, so now the speakers are really beginning to sound very nice. In order to address the remaining improvement areas, I implemented another couple of solutions. The first one is I included a damping resistor in the high pass filter section, so in the section which drives the tweeter. I have found that this improves the sound. The tweeter is more gentle in this way. And also the peak, you might remember, around 1.5, 1.2, 1.5 kHz is again further reduced. Another action was to completely redesign the layout of the crossover. You can see here the final release. And here we have the final frequency response after all the fine tunings, measurement sessions, simulations, listening tests, and so on. So pretty much flat, I would say. And first of all, what's most important, the speakers do sound really, really fantastic in my opinion. So I think I achieved my goal to have a matching speaker for my tube stereo amplifier.